Vic lost the football. Goes out of bounds. New Orleans did not have possession. It's still Atlanta ball, but it's fourth down. Fujita came in and freed it out of Vic's hand.
And kicking off, the former Saint Morton Anderson is here for most field goals. Look out! Right through! A kick block by Steve Gleason. It is scooped and scored by Curtis DeLoach. Touchdown, New Orleans!
Remember, you can't line anybody up over the center. And what they do is they just create this giant gap for Gleason to go through. And he's on the kicker before he ever gets a chance to get it off. Watch how close he is to taking off his hands.
You could not script this any better than it just happened for the New Orleans Saints. Everybody thought that the wave of emotion would come in with the Saints. If you were the Falcons, the first thing you had to be afraid of is being swept away in that particular wave of emotion. That is exactly what happened now. And for those people who look to the New Orleans Saints as something that will uplift them, uplift this city, uplift the entire Gulf region, they just had it.
This is like a slap in the face to the Atlanta Falcons to say, okay, look, we know it's all about the Saints here, but you know what? This is a football game, and we better get ourselves ready for it.
Gain of four, second and six. And Vic to the air. It is complete for a first down at the 40-yard line, caught by Michael Jenkins. But they are so effective doing the safest thing in football, running it. Second and 10, he reads the end and hands it to Ward Dunn. Gain of four, here's Michelle Tafoya. In franchise history, he coached here as an assistant for 5 years. Third down, Vic throwing the deep ball for Ashley Lalee, who holds it in, and he'll be marked down at the 8-yard line. So Lalee, who came via the trade from Denver, hauls in the long strike of 48 yards. Dunn goes right side. Mike McKenzie there for the tackle. Gain of about a yard. Trying to play on offense. Falcons trying to tie the game. And Vic roughs it up. It is incomplete for his security blanket, his tight end, L.G. Crumpler. Blakely, the second tight end in motion in the slot at the top.
You're still looking for L.G. Crumpler.
And he throws that way. Crumpler had to go in and out of his hands. Incomplete. 6-year-old from 26 yards.
I hope that's in his range at 46.
And Morton Anderson back on the scoreboard again in his 355th NFL game. Second on the all-time scoring list. Now 74 points behind Gary Anderson. So after the McAllister gain of three, Bush out in space to the left. The attention goes there. And the pass goes for a first down to Joe Horn at the 34-yard line.
Of course, money helped.
Yeah, 60
yeah. million, it helped.
Breeze throws complete to Marcus, or rather, Devery Henderson. The former LSU Tiger gets the first down to the 48-yard line to pick up a 14. Coach at age 42. After the Atlanta timeout, third and eight. And Breeze's throw is complete to Marcus Colston. Penalty marker down, back at the quarterback. Patrick Kearney was rushing. It may add to a 27-yard gain. Let's see.
Personal foul, roughing the passer. Defense, led with the helmet. 15-yard penalty from the end of the run. First down.
He's out there as the coverage goes to Horn's side. This is first down. It's in the hands of Bush. It's in the hands of Devery Henderson, the former LSU Tiger, in the end zone in the Louisiana Superdome. Touchdown, New Orleans. As people try to come back and try to get some energy back in their city and their lives from their football team. First down run with Reggie Bush. The ball comes out. Jamal Brown falls on it, and it was, in fact, ruled on the field a fumble and a recovery.
One of the greatest I've been. I mean, it's exciting. My hairs are on end. It's a great night.
Here's the second down run for Deuce McAllister, who breaks into the secondary. And McAllister's out to the 45-yard line. Vic tries to make the most of that McAllister play. Falcons back off to zone, and Breeze comes underneath. Complete to Marcus Colston. Here's a guy right up your alley. He's a guy from Hofstra. The third to last player taken in the draft. Became a rookie starter. He's done a terrific job. First down at the 40-yard line.
New York.
I need to show you some of those as the night goes on. On first down, Breeze pumps left, comes back right. It was high, but Joe Horn went up to get it. May have hurt. May have gotten hurt on that. He sure did. 17 yards as Joe comes down. Breeze is pressured, throws incomplete. Fans want a flag and get it. But the Falcons are saying, Joey, that it was deflected.
Yeah, after the ball is tipped at the line of scrimmage, you can hit a receiver. Now the officials are doing an excellent job of conferring.
As many assistant coaches as some teams
defense,
have.
Number 56. The ball is placed at the spot of the foul. First down.
This is 75, Ron Coleman.
Atlanta's challenging the ruling on the field. The ball was not touched before the pass interference.
Read Jim's lips. 75, Rod Coleman was the one who tipped it. So Jim Mora and the Falcons challenging this pass interference flag on third down. Answer when we come back.
His mind has to be when.
The ball was tipped by defensive player number 75 before the pass interference. Therefore, there is no foul on the play by rule. It'll therefore be an incomplete pass. It's fourth and six on the 19.
Who he followed, Reeves, had a bad record, and his dad, Jim Mora, had a bad replay record.
Well, he got one right.
John Carney, 37-yard field goal. Saints lead by 14. And find themselves trailing by 14 points here in the second. Kickoff return by Jarius Norwood, the rookie out of Mississippi State. Shown the sideline at the 42 and a 15-yard flag tacked on as Curtis DeLoach got too intense. And his head coach, Sean Payton's right there to tell him, you can't do that for the dome. Second and 10. Vic has space. Fakes out Fujita, but good pursuit by Hollis Thomas. They run on third and 5. And they're going to come up a yard shy with the Justin Griffith carry. The fullback getting just his second effort as a ball carrier. And they will choose to throw it and complete it to Algie Crumpler, tackled by Josh Bullock's first down at the 16.
12 men on the field, defense. The penalty is declined. The play results in a first down.
Slips as he tries to cut back. Charles Grant, fifth-year man out of Georgia, former first-round pick.
There's
Vic now dancing out, lofting it complete to Griffith. And he is shy of the end zone down at the 2-yard line. Ex-center Eric Beverly, now a tight end, came in motion. Vic brought down. Brian Young, the 70-year veteran with the sack.
Phil, that's what they look at. Lots of them.
Morton Anderson, good from 26, is blocked on this 25-yard attempt. What a night it's been for the special teams. Josh Bullets, the safety, came in to get that. And Joe DiCamillis, the special teams coach.
See what you can get, and you try and get into a field goal position.
Atlanta has one timeout left. Deuce McAllister takes it to the 18-yard line. Jason Webster, Lawyer Malloy there on the tack. Second and 5 from the 18. Breeze throws complete to Colston. They equal their 3 win total all year. Reggie Bush right at the first down line. And we'll see here with 59 seconds. Peyton continuing to let the clock run. Rico, Argentina, and Lithuania, 2 years after the U.S. fell on its face in the World Championships in Indianapolis. Bush screams. Reggie to the sideline to 41. Gain of 3. Lexus halftime show coming up. Chris Berman, Steve Young, Michael Irvin, Tom Jackson, Stewart. And one timeout and 28 seconds to try to accomplish that. And a handoff inside to Bush. Gets to the edge. Can't get out of bounds as Reggie's taken down at the 49-yard line. His attorney, we met with him yesterday, knocked down some of the claims. Reeves here with 19 seconds, pitches it to Bush, who runs to the sideline and gets there at the 49-yard line to stop the clock. Mathis took a shot at Joe Horn, and that was a bad penalty. Add 15 yards, and the Saints are going to be very close to field goal range. and the emotion.
After the play was over, personal foul, unnecessary roughness, defense number 23, 15-yard penalty, first down.
Community at their time of need before playing a game in here. Final seconds, Breeze without timeouts, has to be the sidelines, and they almost lost yardage on the pass to Henderson. So from here, you're looking at a 51-yard field goal attempt with 5 seconds left, and all Henderson can do is say, hey, I had to get out of bounds back into the half.
It's the oldest two kickers since the Rockettes had a reunion from the 1945 Rockettes.
From 51, online, is it long enough? You betcha.
Does everything go right now for the New Orleans Saints in their first game here in 14 months?
New Orleans will get the ball to start the third. Vic and the Falcons stymied. Saints 20, Falcons 3. Here's Chris Berman with the Lexus. For the kickoff and before the first play, John Leak was shaken up for the Falcons. He walked off under his own power. On first down, Breeze throws complete to Marcus Colston again. Turns down, tackles, and takes it into Falcons territory. A couple of this city still call home. Breeze pumps deep, gets it to McAllister to the 39-yard line. Three shy of a first down.
Gel. They've done a terrific job giving him a chance to stand back there and throw the ball.
McAllister runs for a first down. Michael Boley and DeMario Williams made the tackle, and we should reiterate that Atlanta's without two starters on defense here again tonight. And Joe Horn in motion. Breeze to Horn. First down, 13-yard line. On this drive. Breeze, quick toss. Colston caught it at the 5. Jason Webster makes the tackle to set up 3rd and 2. Deuce McAllister in the backfield. Mike Carney, the fullback, leads the way. McAllister, first down and goal. First and goal. They anticipate Deuce. They've got Deuce. Deuce is down. Here is Reggie bouncing it to the outside, trying to cut back in. But he is stopped for virtually no gain. Michael Boley and Jason Webster force 3rd and goal. Colston in motion. It is Bush who is stopped.
Time would work.
Shy of the 1. And the Saints have an extra point-sized field goal here if they so choose. It becomes an extra point that's worth 3. Carney bangs it through. There's a terrific drive. You come out of the locker room, you know Michael Vick salivating to get his hands on the ball. You take half the quarter, get points, and take a 20-point lead. Care about the game with their rooting interest. Don't believe it. They do get it right. Reggie Bush gains almost 9 yards. The one in movement on the tight end, Mark Campbell. They say he stayed in his stance, and McAllister runs close to a first down. A lot of things.
You'd have to rank them in order at some point for me.
No, sir. 3rd and 7, and Breeze is finally brought down. That's the first pressure of the night. Kevin Mathis bringing it off a safety blitz. You are watching tonight with heavy hearts and a lot of happiness, too, as Vic gets out of his sack, keeps it alive, dumps it to Algie Crumpler, who gets a first down to the 28-yard line.
One that everybody has been in their hip pockets.
Vic takes off, finally able to get a first down and more. The magic of Michael Vick. Yeah. Hauled in by Jenkins for the first down at the 30-yard line. This game, regular season here since the end of 04. 3rd down, Vick eludes 1, not the 2nd. Charles Grant will get credit.
But again, it's Bryant Young, number 66. Has been able to come up the middle and be in Michael Vick's face all day.
And as he throws, adjustment by Jenkins, didn't hold it down, but the flag came down.
This is incomplete. Pass interference, offense number 12. The penalty is declined. First down.
This must be so frustrating to Atlanta. They come into a circumstance where it's the Saints' first home game in over a year, and they think and they feel that everyone is rooting against them, and it's probably true. Everyone probably is rooting against them. And they can get nothing done, even though for the first 2 weeks they look like one of the best teams in the National Football League. Running over Carolina, right? Running over Tampa Bay. They came in here, they probably had to think, okay, we take the crowd out of it, we run over New Orleans.
Work together. That is the way he will approach it, and that will serve him well.
Third down, Marcus Colston, who fits that mold to a T, gets the first down at the 45-yard line. Vic sacked again by Will Smith again. Five New Orleans sacks. A score. Third and six, they're just running to cut your losses here and get on out. Griffith with the tackle, we'll have fourth down coming up. You know, guys, as this game wraps up here tonight, you think people are going to enjoy, they're going to celebrate, they'll have a good time. Tomorrow morning's going to come, and all the problems that people had in New Orleans are still going to be here. But for tonight, they were given a chance to step away and enjoy a moment in this dome that some never thought they would see again. Saints 3-0. Tom Benson with the parasol, the owner out on the field as the joyous Saints wrap up this night. As they say in New Orleans, laissez le bon temps rouler, let the good times roll. And for the Saints fans, it will tonight. There's complete coverage of the evening and this memorable day in New Orleans coming up on Sports Center.
Saints are back. What's going through your mind when you come out of the blocks on fire?
I feel so good for the fans. They've been through so much, Susie. It's a great feeling. It's a wonderful feeling. We've been working hard. Coach Payton is doing a hell of a job. Got all the guys focused on one job and task, and that's to win every week. It's just an exciting feeling for everybody in this place because so many people went through a lot. We went through a lot as football players, but the fans, Mississippi, New Orleans, Louisiana, went through so much, and I'm happy for the fans.
What moment from tonight will last in your mind forever?
Oh, wow. Just looking back at the fans after the clock ran out, looking at the smiles, looking at the tears that I saw, was fabulous. It was unbelievable.
After last season, what does it feel like to be 3-0?
It feels good. It feels good, but like Coach Payton always tell us, we're going to eat it up tonight, digest it tomorrow, and Tuesday we're going to go back to work because we know 3-0 can easily turn into 3-13. It can easily turn into 3-13, and we're not going to let that happen.
Congratulations.
Thank you, sweetheart. Take care of yourself.
Fourth time.
I don't know if you can hear me that well. We got the music going next door, but it's a special night. We gave the game ball to the city of New Orleans. Let me say it again so you guys can hear me. We gave the game ball tonight to the city of New Orleans. Avery Johnson accepted that on behalf of this city, and I couldn't think anybody in this town would be more proud to have hold on to that football. I thought from start to finish, our guys played hard, gave great effort. I'm proud of the way they played. We had a great week of preparation to carry it over into this game. And when you come to a game like this, with everything that's going on, the ability to focus at the job at hand and stay focused and play each down, each play, each series, each quarter is critical. I thought we did that tonight.
This was a special game for a lot of people. You know, everyone in this city, community, Gulf Coast, you know, us as a team and an organization. So tonight, you know, we're going to celebrate this thing. It was very, very special. But tomorrow, we're going to treat it as just another win. And obviously, we got, you know, another divisional game coming up this next week against Carolina, and we'll be on to the next game. I mean, it was really a must-win mentality because we said the only way this night's going to be special is if we win this game. You know, that's what the fans deserve. That's what this whole city, community, region deserves. And, you know, that's what we deserve as a team. So we owed it to everybody to get it done.